President Obama has appointed fewer federal judges than any other president in modern time, and a lot of that has to do with pure, ridiculous Republican obstruction. They want judges in place that are going to help them stop the vote in this country. That's the real heart of this issue. I have Mike Burg with me now to talk about that. Mike, about a year ago, we started doing stories about the idea that the judicial appointments that are being made by this administration are, it's an emergency situation. They simply are not being made. And there was two parts to the story, and I want us to talk about both parts. First of all, even the recommendations that were coming through this administration were federal judges that would scare the hell out of any consumer who actually knew their background. It would scare to death union people. It would scare to death environmentalists. It would scare to death labor. Even those appointments that were coming through Obama were very troublesome. But now we're finding that the Republicans have even obstructed those appointments because, and you know the zinger here, they don't want federal judges in place appointed by this administration because of the upcoming elections, because they want to mess with the voting system in America. Isn't that how you see this story?
It is. There's two parts to it. And the first one, I agree with you. The nominees that he's been putting up are scary for anybody who has any type of interest in consumer rights. And one of the things that's interesting is I know you, the public may not know this, but Elizabeth Warren, Senator Warren, just came out and leaked the story that one of the reasons that's happening is that the administration is going through Williams and Connolly to get their approval and the vetting. And we all know Williams and Connolly is notorious for representing political and corporate criminals who are being charged with crimes to get them off. They're one of the leading firms in the country that represents the largest corporations in the world.
Mike, they've been sanctioned by judges for things like discovery, improper elements of how they've been involved with discovery, where one party is asking for information and there's cover-up of that information, there's obstruction of that information. So Williams and Connolly is like Colonel Sanders guarding the chicken house, and this administration knows it. You know, Michelle Obama is a lawyer herself, defense lawyer herself. Obama's a lawyer himself. He understands what it means to get these kinds of appointments through people like Williams and Connolly. It is Colonel Sanders at the chicken house, isn't it?
Right. Absolutely. But what's crazy now is the GOP is not happy with that, which we all know those appointments would be potentially devastating to all those interest groups that we talked about. They're trying to basically shut down the judiciary. Shut them down completely. There are absolutely 96 vacancies, one-third of the federal judiciary vacant as we sit here today. There's 39 judicial emergencies where those districts are so overloaded that they need judges so badly. And yet, even those appointments that have been handpicked by Williams and Connolly, the GOP and the Republicans are shutting it down because they do not want this administration to have any appointments.
Okay, now before we move from that Williams and Connolly point, let's make it clear to the listeners. First of all, A, they represent the oil industry, they represent Wall Street, they represent anti-labor almost at every turn of the way. They are anti-consumer. Virtually everything they do is anti-consumer. And this president says, I'm going to use them as the clearinghouse for who I'm going to appoint. And to say that he's unaware of that is ridiculous. Now, let's move to another point. A year ago, Mike, you were talking about the idea that if appointments are made by this administration, even if they're not too great of an appointment, they nevertheless are a Democratic administration appointment, right?
That's true.
Now, the Republicans, and you talked about this a year ago, you said the Republicans are going to try to gain control of the federal judiciary where they can stop any type of election reform that's going to prevent people from going to the polls. If you have a judge that won't allow laws to be passed that prevent, you know, that actually help people, encourage people to go to the polls, then the Republicans, that's a victory for them. I mean, you were talking about this a year ago, and sure enough, now other people are talking about this. What's your take now?
Well, same thing. And now they're putting into effect. What's interesting here is the Democrats try to change the rules on the filibuster, thinking that will open the doors for these federal judiciary appointments. But there's all kinds of rules and shenanigans that are going on in the GOP that are keeping these people, even those that have been approved by their senators. What's crazy is a senator may go ahead and approve an individual to go through the process, and now they're pulling tricks and games and shenanigans to keep the vote from coming to the floor to have those judges appointed.
Well, Michael, People for the American Way have been writing some really good material on this. They point out that in 5 minutes, 32, now listen, 32 judges could be appointed in 5 minutes. But what's happened is the Republicans have put together they're using obstruction methodology. And by the way, Leahy, who is in charge of the committee, has let him get away with it. Leahy is a Democrat. Leahy is allowing this to go on. Isn't that troublesome in itself? I mean, Leahy allows him to use all of these tricks. Now that filibuster at least has been somewhat pushed back, the Republicans will say, well, now let's use some of this stuff that's never been used. What are the couple of the things that they do besides not showing up for the vote?
Yeah. Number one, they don't show up for the vote. Number two, they have the right to have a certain number of hours for each judge to be approved. And when you add that all up, to get those 32 that were already approved and ready to go, 204 hours to clear the nominees that have already gone through. Well, they would have to shut down the Senate for all other business to try to get that done, when in fact, as you mentioned, Mike, and absolutely it's true, they could do it in 5 minutes, an up and down vote. A yes or no vote, in 5 minutes you can get those cleared, but they're demanding for the full amount of time, which basically shuts down the process.
To show you how crazy this is, let's just use a couple of examples. You have Marco Rubio, for example, from Florida. Okay, Marco Rubio personally recommended a man by the name of William Thomas. He's the guy who fought for him. He put him up there. And now Marco Rubio in Florida is the guy that's preventing William Thomas from being appointed to that seat. Now, first of all, for Marco Rubio to even agree to William Thomas is extraordinary. And if you look at William Thomas's history, you see why Rubio would agree that this fellow should be appointed. I mean, the guy is anything but a great consumer judge. I mean, he's going to hurt consumers in the worst kind of way. But now Rubio says, we're not going to even allow him to be appointed. And why? It comes back to what you talked about a year ago. If they control the judiciary, okay, if they have more Republicans in the judiciary than the Democrats, they have a better chance of pushing through anti-voting kind of legislation. Isn't that exactly what we see happening right now?
Absolutely, and we predicted it a year ago. The bottom line is this. What they're hoping for, and the listeners have to understand that, first of all, the judiciary is the last chance for the public when it comes to voting rights, when it comes to the ability to bring actions into court. And the Republicans are saying, look, let's stop all the nominations from going through. Because you know what? We think maybe in the mid-year we're going to get control of the Senate. We get control of the Senate, then we can vote down everything, even if we have a Democratic president that follows Obama. But the next 2 years, we're going to shut down the judiciary, shut down the trial lawyers, shut down anybody who can go after these anti-voting rights acts. And that's the intent.
Right now, Mike, in the Eastern District of Michigan, you've got the judges there are saying this is an emergency. We can't even try hardened criminals. We can't try drug cartel. We can't try white-collar criminals that have ripped the American public up for billions of dollars. We can't even get them to trial because we don't have enough judges. Not only that, we don't have enough clerks to help move this thing through, because with a judge comes clerks, and the clerks and the judge together moves the process. But what's happened here, I think it's very clear. They have a clear intent to going forward. Now, my question, Mike, and I don't understand this. If we assume that Leahy has the right, he's the chairman of the committee. Leahy has the right of this to say to a senator, you know, that right that you have, it's called a blue slip. The right. Blue slip is the senator can come forward and say, I don't have to give a reason for why I don't want this judge. I just don't want the judge. Blue slips are flying around like crazy in the Beltway by Republican senators. And it's all, and they're even being used against the very people that they nominated to begin with.
Right.
What do you tell Leahy?
Well, you got to tell Leahy, we got to step. First of all, the blue slips have never been used in any other administration like this. And I want to go back to your point about emergency. There's 39 judicial emergencies, not only in the Eastern District of Michigan, but all over the country. You got to tell Leahy, stop messing around with them. Force them to bring the vote to the floor. We have 32 that have already been approved by the committee. Get those votes to the floor. Tell the Republicans no blue slips, no avoiding it. We're going to have a vote up and down. Force the issue. Get to the American people to put pressure on them.
They are like mentally ill children. That's the best description I've heard of the Republicans right now in the Beltway. Mentally ill, vitriolic children. That is the description that best describes what the Republicans are doing up there. And they're doing it because they want to stop voting in this country. That is one of the main reasons behind all of this.